personal is on this road. Social is here, professional is here. Those are all the strengths. And that's everything, and I'm talking about research. I'm talking about years and years and years of research, working with athletes, talking to athletes, helping athletes. This is the strength. This is what it looks like. But a lot of this stuff is not in the curriculum. A lot of the personal development stuff is not in the handbook. Now I'm gonna tell you, this athletic identity thing, once you get caught up, it's not a male, female, black, white, or you come from the suburbs, or you come from the side, it don't matter. It's a culture. Everybody in this room, you're going through one of those. At some point in time, but you go on a trip, you go up to Washington State, right? It's a journey. You take that journey all the way. You go to the airport, you get on a plane, then you land, then you go to the hotel and you check in. Right? Then you got a game or a match or whatever it is, you check in on Friday. Your game is Saturday. What's gonna happen? Either Saturday night or Sunday, what's gonna happen? You check out, right? But you know that before you get there, right? A lot of athletes that come to college don't think like that. I mean, it's so simple. They don't think they're gonna check out. Don't be like, oh man, I'm not redshirt. I'm gonna transfer. Because they want me to redshirt, really? So let me get this straight now. They're gonna give you an extra year to work on your personal, social, and professional. Give you an extra year to get a little bit bigger. Give you an extra year to get a little bit stronger. Give you an extra year to learn the layout of the campus, get to develop some relationships, and you want to leave. What's the rush? The institution, these folks here, they got expectations. They want you to maintain the eligibility. They want you to go out and produce on the field or on the track or on the court. They want you to graduate. Those are their expectations. Who's sleeping closer than this to the phone? That's right. Do you sleep with the phone on? No, you know you do stop looking around. Why wouldn't you? Okay, all right. So now you're going to play those kind of games. So anyway, I call you at 3 o'clock in the damn morning. And you answer the phone. And you, I say, what's your name?
Noah.
Noah. What's up, Blair? You say, God, I'm asleep. Then why you answer the damn phone? I say, what you doing? I say, oh, nothing, man, just chilling. You know you asleep, dog. But you want to know what I'm doing. See, you want to know what I'm doing. That's